Let's start by making it reasonable. Mitchell Trubisky will always be the guy the Bears traded up to take in front of Patrick Mahomes and Deshaun Watson. Nothing is going to change that.
Yeah.
That doesn't, however, have to impact our judgment of how good or bad he is. Why did he look so awful yesterday?
Well, mechanically, he's a mess. And that's been the story of his season, is his feet are all over the place. He's the only quarterback that throws with both feet off the ground, and it affects his accuracy so much. The best way to describe him right now and the impact he's having on the football team, because Matt Nagy is now getting too creative with stuff. Like, he's trying to find ways to have something positive happen for this offense, and they're getting too kind of tricky or too cute, and they can't turn to anything for this offense that they go, you know what, when things aren't going well, we can go do this. And it's affecting their play calling. I guess the best analogy I have is, like, right now Mitchell Trubisky's a zit. Like, you're trying to find, you know it's a bad situation, and you're trying any way you can to cover it up, and that cover-up is only making things worse with that situation.
Some zinc oxide or whatever you want to put on this zit might be to run the football. What the hell? They don't run the football anymore.
They can't.
And to me, I mean, you got a struggling quarterback. Hey, I'm not the smartest cat of all time, but when we struggle, we ran the football down your throat. And that's what you got to do right now. This kid is playing with zero confidence. And when you look at it, hey, the GM was the guru. He got GM of the year or the decade or whatever, because Mitch Trubisky was, he was Maserati Mitch. Yeah, well, guess what? We got to go back. The kids lost confidence. You got to find a way to get confidence. And the way you do that is run the football and put it in somebody else's hand. And by the way, sit back and say, come on, let's go.
How about this? Yesterday, he's coming off of being out with the dislocated shoulder and the torn labrum. They ran the ball the least amount of times in a game ever in the history of their organization, 7 times.
Well, that's exactly what I'm talking
about. That's not great, Bob. I mean, obviously, those types of numbers aren't great, especially in Chicago. And I think you're always going to have buyer's remorse whenever you draft a guy ahead of three potential MVP candidates. And you also got to add in Christian McCaffrey, who he was drafted ahead of, who has been dominating football this year. But with that being said, earlier in the year, we were talking about this defense being this 2000 Ravens, 85 Bears defense. They were wrecking games. They were all of these things. It feels as if that defense has lost their soul, almost like they lost their drive to succeed, because they know if they get the ball on the offensive side, they're not going to do anything. I mentioned this about the Cowboys, about trading for a quarterback. I often wonder if Cam Newton, who in the Carolina Panthers have been unbeatable without him playing, coming back from a Mrs. Frank injury, if he was to get traded to the Bears, would they be better immediately? I say yes. I think that is an accurate thing, and I think Bears fans would all be excited about that as well.
I feel like we would be remiss, though, if we talked about this game and we didn't mention for 1 second what Sean Payton did yesterday.
Because
it's a lot about what the Bears didn't do. He didn't have Elvin Kamara. He doesn't have Drew Brees. Mm-hmm. And meanwhile, he went toe-to-toe with that Chicago and absolutely railroaded them. Can we talk about what they did and what the Saints are currently doing?
Yeah, I mean, that's half your roster's not there. And yet, you know how they won? They dominated both lines of scrimmage with their offensive line and their defensive line. They totally dominated this tough Chicago Bear team that, to me, looks like paper champions.
Yeah, right now they're the best team in football, and Sean Payton's the second best coach in football right now.
Who's the first?
Belichick. I'm not.
Okay.
Bill Belichick's the best coach in football, but Sean Payton's the second best right now.
Best team in football. Aaron Rodgers on line two may have another idea.
Okay.
Yeah, how about?
Thank you for watching ESPN on YouTube. For more sports highlights and analysis, be sure to download the ESPN app. And for live streaming sports and premium content, subscribe to ESPN+.